Now, from a system manager's point of view, one of the most useful little widgets here is this in the data section. You'll find a plugin for editing the archive, for looking at current values, and also for looking at stale and bad tags. So for current values, what we're simply saying is you can go out and search for all of your PI tags, or a subset of your PI tags. There we go. I'll select all of these. And what we're going to do is show you what their current value is. So here are the current values. If you want, you can force this to auto-update so you can see these change in real time. Obviously, though, we have much better tools for getting up-to-date data, a process book, for example, data link, and if you want to bring it into Excel. But as you can see, as a quick and dirty tool, it's a fine way to look at the data. And there is an option here to export this to a file. Now take a look at Archive Editor. With the Archive Editor, you can find a PI tag and then edit its value. And if you do edit any of these values, there's specific flags that will go ahead and trigger if you do edit. So for example, let me go back. Let's get a little bit more. How about the last 8 hours worth of data for this tag sinusoid? And if I'd like to edit its value, for example, I know for a fact that was actually 100. I'll go ahead and put in edit value. I'll go ahead and type in the actual value. I'll go ahead and save that. And you'll notice this little flag here called substituted is indicating to me that there's been a substitution at this point. You can also add annotations. So again, using this value, I can go ahead and add an annotation and just say this was corrected by admin. And if you don't put in by whom, don't worry about that. Any of these changes are going to be stored in our audit database if you've got that feature turned on. But as you can see, we've indicating here that there's been an annotation. And by the way, that annotation will show up in different clients. For example, you can show that in Process Book Trend, or you can bring that into Excel. Now, the last, this questionable, is something that certain of our interfaces will support. So if that's something that you're interested in, take a look at your interface documentation. See if it supports setting things to questionable, you know, under certain circumstances of data collection. Now, lastly, you can, of course, add new values at the end. For example, I'll put in a value of 50, and I'll say that happened, let's go with T plus 7 hours. That's today at 7 o'clock in the morning. I'll go ahead and save it. And that should give us a value of 50 at 7 a.m. So let's go back minus 1 day. And here's our value of 50, recorded at 7 a.m. Now, of course, this is all supposing that you have the proper credentials using the security so that you have permission to write to these tags. Now, finally, this plugin right here for stale and bad points, what this is going to do is it's going to allow you to go out and find what are considered stale or bad tags in your system. By stale, meaning the values have not been changing. And you get to set what that criteria is. So, for example, anywhere between the last, say, 4 hours to the last 365 days, if you haven't changed, then what we'll see is those values are going to be reported as stale values.